is looking at Turkey. Mm-hmm.
Will you ask for an extension of the SALT agreement in Geneva?
Preferite,
sì, 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 s
again say welcome to the White House, and also a great thank you for your role in world affairs. We appreciate your support for our arms control policies. We were asked about that by the press, and we didn't answer. And have been, now there are more things that I will talk about in a moment about the appreciation that we have for the cooperation and support that we've had from you, but right now in my mind very much is the fact that you just had a meeting with a gentleman. Even that was a small head.
Thank you for those pictures.
I'll go first. I'm honored today to welcome Prime Minister Craxi back to the United States. Since your visit in October of 1983, Mr. Prime Minister, you've taken on a new responsibility, assuming the presidency of the European Community. We're pleased to have had this opportunity to meet with you as a friend, as a leader of a great nation, and as the representative of the European peoples. Cooperation between Italy and the United States is at a level unsurpassed in our history. Your country, Mr. Prime Minister, is an ally second to none. Our efforts have kept the peace in Europe for almost 40 years. Italy has played an active role in the cause of peace. It continues to do so today in the Middle East, an area which, as Prime Minister Craxi explained, is of special importance to Italy. And today the Prime Minister and I also discussed East-West relations and arms control. We reviewed the approach the United States will take in the coming Geneva talks. The Prime Minister reconfirmed Italy's continued steadfastness on INF development. Deployment, I should say. We also discussed the Strategic Defense Initiative. The Prime Minister assured me of Italy's full understanding of the program's objectives, and we agreed on the great potential benefits this research effort could provide. We firmly agree that now is the time for alliance solidarity, and our goal remains the reduction and eventual elimination of the means of aggression, nuclear and conventional. In another area of cooperation, we look forward to a productive Bonn summit. I affirm to the Prime Minister the high priority we place on undertaking a new round of trade negotiations by early 1986. These talks are necessary, not just to forestall a possible slide back toward protectionism, but to take new steps for freer and more open trade and a stronger world economy. The United States and Italy are two of the world's great democracies, our bilateral relations reflecting our shared values are on a high plane. When the Prime Minister last visited, we decided to improve our coordination and cooperation against narcotics. And I'm happy to report that our initiative has now yielded an effective new instrument to combat this scourge, our binational working group on narcotics and organized crime. Our common fight against terrorism is another area of close cooperation, and Italy deserves accolades for its courageous struggle against terrorism. I know I speak for all Americans in thanking you publicly, Mr. Prime Minister, for Italy's successful thwarting last November of a potential bomb attack against our embassy in Rome. As the head of a vital, vibrant democracy, nurtured by statesmen like yourself and your illustrious predecessors, you and your coalition partners have put Italy in the forefront of the world's functioning democracies. You've demonstrated your unequivocal and compelling commitment to Western values. We're grateful to the Italian people as our friends and allies. And we're also proud, Mr. Prime Minister, to welcome your historic address to the Congress tomorrow. It will, I'm certain, be another milestone in the numerous and long-lasting ties between our two countries. Mr. Prime Minister, America welcomes you with her warmest friendship, and we salute you and your partners and wish you continued success.
Amica dell'Italia ha assunto anche un carattere particolare in relazione alla responsabilità che nell'attuale semestre discendono all'Italia quale paese che esercita la presidenza di turno delle comunità europee. I nostri colloqui sono stati approfonditi, aperti e molto costruttivi. Al presidente Reagan ho rinnovato le vive congratulazioni del governo italiano e mie personali per il grande consenso e l'ampio mandato ricevuti alle recenti elezioni presidenziali. Mi sono anche felicitato per i successi riportati nell'espansione economica che ha consentito una forte crescita dell'occupazione. Gli Stati Uniti sono riusciti nella difficile azione di conciliare l'ammodernamento dei processi produttivi con la creazione di nuovi posti di lavoro. Europa e Stati Uniti dovrebbero operare insieme con azioni ed iniziative coordinate che sono necessarie per migliorare la collaborazione economica transatlantica nel reciproco vantaggio. Ho espresso al presidente Reagan le mie valutazioni sui temi che l'Italia segue con la massima attenzione, in primo luogo i temi della pace, della sicurezza, dello sviluppo, della difesa dei diritti dei popoli. Ho anche illustrato i programmi e le prospettive dei 10 per una più ampia integrazione comunitaria. Ho sottolineato come la nostra volontà di progredire verso la Unione Europea si colloca nell'ottica di un costante rafforzamento della partnership euro-americana in un rapporto equilibrato e di più efficace corresponsabilità. Anche in questa visita ho potuto riscontrare quanto profondi e stretti permangano i legami di amicizia, alleanza e cooperazione che uniscono l'Italia agli Stati Uniti ed è nostro proposito di continuare a consolidarli. Ho particolarmente apprezzato la considerazione speciale per l'Italia e per lo sviluppo dei rapporti italo-americani espressami dal presidente Reagan e dai suoi collaboratori. Considero tale attenzione come una testimonianza della coerenza e dell'impegno con cui il governo italiano concorre in modo positivo alla ricerca di più stabili equilibri internazionali, non solo nel campo della difesa, ma anche in quello degli equilibri economici e politici. Nel nostro scambio di valutazioni sono risultate confermate ampie e incoraggianti convergenze. Sono convinto che gli obiettivi fondamentali della politica degli Stati Uniti restano la difesa e la pace basata sull'equilibrio delle forze. Il presidente Reagan mi ha assicurato che questi stessi obiettivi saranno perseguiti con l'iniziativa di difesa strategica dal cui programma di ricerca potremmo trarre mutui benefici nel campo scientifico e tecnologico. Annettiamo una fondamentale importanza alle possibilità di successo di negoziati riapertisi a Ginevra. Partiamo dalla convinzione che una riduzione sostanziale, equa e verificabile degli armamenti costituisce la condizione essenziale per una più sicura e più stabile pace. Lavoreremo perché sia cresciuto il clima di fiducia, perché questo negoziato e quelli che si sviluppano in altri fori possano svolgersi nelle circostanze più favorevoli possibili. Il processo negoziale non è sostituibile ed una intesa sulla progressiva eliminazione bilanciata degli armamenti e per una organizzazione della pace fondata su equilibri riconosciuti ed accettati è nell'interesse di tutti. Abbiamo discusso della situazione in Medio Oriente e constatato con compiacimento l'emergere di segnali positivi suscettibili di riattivare il processo negoziale per una soluzione politica della crisi arabo-israeliana. Abbiamo entrambi preso nota con interesse del recente dialogo giordano-palestinese e delle intese realizzate nella speranza che esse consentano di giungere sollecitamente ad una posizione araba congiunta per l'avvio di negoziati realistici con Israele. Siamo rimasti d'accordo di tenerci in contatto per poter assecondare efficacemente ogni movimento positivo in direzione di una pace giusta, globale e durevole in Medio Oriente. Nei miei colloqui a Washington abbiamo anche esaminato la situazione economica internazionale, confrontando le nostre idee sui modi e i mezzi per consolidare e rafforzare la ripresa in un quadro di maggiore stabilità. Dobbiamo meglio armonizzare gli sforzi nazionali per valorizzare appieno i benefici effetti della ripresa sui livelli occupazionali. Ma non possiamo limitare la nostra attenzione al benessere delle nostre economie. Ci sono problemi gravi e di una gravità crescente ed allarmante nel sud del mondo che noi dobbiamo aiutare a risolvere. Ci siamo trovati d'accordo nell'incoraggiare una efficace consultazione tra i nostri governi su questi temi, anche allo scopo di assicurare successo al vertice dei paesi industrializzati che avrà luogo il 2-4 maggio a Bonn. Reduce da un viaggio nell'America Latina, ho sottolineato nei miei colloqui tutta l'importanza del ritorno della democrazia in civilissime nazioni di quel continente e ho ricordato la speranza di solidarietà democratica dei popoli che rivendicano un regime di libertà. Lo scorso anno definì con il presidente Reagan le intese per una più incisiva collaborazione bilaterale nella lotta contro la droga e la criminalità organizzata e i risultati sono stati importanti e positivi. La collaborazione si è realizzata con reciproca soddisfazione. Continueremo questi sforzi e cercheremo al tempo stesso di migliorare le intese bilaterali e multilaterali per difendere i nostri ordinamenti democratici da ogni ritornante minaccia del terrorismo internazionale. Ringrazio ancora il Presidente Reagan per il fruttuoso scambio di vedute. Ne ho tratto conferma di quanto i comuni valori e le comuni aspirazioni in un contesto di consolidata amicizia facilitino le reciproche comprensioni e le intese sui modi di affrontare e risolvere i problemi che vedono impegnata la responsabilità dei nostri governi e dei nostri paesi.
I wish to thank President Reagan for the warm welcome he has extended to me. My visit to this great friendly nation has a particular importance in view of the responsibilities which fall upon Italy now that it is holding the presidency of the European Community. Our talks have been extensive, open, and very constructive. I have renewed to President Reagan the heartfelt congratulations of the Italian government and my own personal ones for the great consensus received at the recent presidential elections. I have also congratulated him for his success in expanding the American economy, which has resulted in greater employment. The United States has succeeded in the hard task of combining modernization of productivity with the creation of new jobs. Europe and the United States should work together to achieve coordinated action and initiatives which are necessary to improve transatlantic economic cooperation to mutual benefit. I have expressed to President Reagan my assessment of the issues which Italy follows with the utmost attention. First of all, those of peace, security, development, and the safeguarding of the rights of peoples. And while also illustrating the programs and prospects of the 10 for a wider community integration, I have stressed that our willingness to proceed towards European unity is consonant with a framework of constant strengthening of the European-American partnership through a balanced relationship and more effective mutual responsibility. Again, on this occasion, I have realized how deep and strong are the bonds of friendship, alliance, and cooperation between Italy and the United States. It is our firm intention to continue to strengthen them. I have particularly appreciated the special consideration shown by President Reagan and his administration for Italy and for the development of Italian-American relations. I consider this attention as a recognition of the consistency and the commitment shown by the Italian government in making a positive contribution to the search of more stable international equilibria in the field of defense, as well in the economic and political ones. Our exchange of views confirmed the existence of broad and encouraging convergence, since I am convinced that the basic goals of the United States policy remain defense and peace based on a balance of forces. The President has assured me that these same goals will be pursued through the SDI, from whose research program we will draw mutual advantages in the scientific and technological field. We attach a fundamental importance to the success of the forthcoming Geneva negotiations. We are firmly convinced that a substantial, balanced, and verifiable reduction of armaments is the essential condition for a stable and safer peace. We will work hard to strengthen confidence so that this negotiation and those which are taking place in other fora may develop under the best possible circumstances. There are no substitutes for the negotiation process. An agreement on a gradual and balanced elimination of armaments and on the organization of peace based on an accepted and recognized balance is in the interest of all. We have discussed the Middle East situation and noted with satisfaction the emergence of positive signs indicating that there is a possibility of reactivating the negotiation process towards a political solution of the Arab-Israeli crisis. We both noted with interest the recent Jordanian-Palestinian dialogue. We hope that this agreement will shortly allow for a joint Arab stand on the opening of realistic negotiations with Israel. We agreed to keep in constant contact in order to effectively support all positive steps towards a just, global, and lasting peace in the Middle East. In my talks here in Washington, we also examined the international economic situation. and exchanged views on ways and means to consolidate and strengthen economic recovery within a context of greater stability. We must harmonize our national efforts so that the beneficial results of recovery will be fully reflected on the occupational levels. However, we cannot pay attention only to our own economic prosperity. The increasing serious problems in the third world are a matter of great concern. We must help in seeking solutions to them. We agreed to hold effective consultations between our governments on these issues in order to ensure the success of the Summit Conference of the Industrialized Nations, which will take place in Bonn on May 2nd to the 4th. Having just visited Latin America, I also emphasized in my talks here the great importance of the return of democracy in the highly civilized nations of that continent, and drew attention to the expectations for the democratic solidarity of the peoples living there who aspire to a regime based on freedom. Last year, I worked out with President Reagan a program for a more effective bilateral cooperation in the fight against drug traffic and organized crime. The results have been positive and significant. Our cooperation has been carried out with mutual satisfaction. We will continue these efforts while trying at the same time to improve bilateral and multilateral agreements so as to defend our democratic system against any rise of the threat of international terrorism. I wish to thank President Reagan for this fruitful exchange of views. It was, for me, a confirmation of how much the sharing of values and aspirations in a context of long-standing friendship makes it easier to reach mutual understanding and agreement on how to cope with and solve problems for which we have responsibilities, not only as governments, but for which we have responsibilities to our own peoples.
Cut!